Having a moon, a brave princess defeats a giant crab. Long ago, a giant crab lived in a deep hole at the bottom of the sea. Twice a day, it would crawl out to search for food. When it left its home, the hole would fill up with water. Since the crab was so large, it took all of the water along the shore to fill the hole. When the crab finished eating, it crawled back into his home. The water was forced back out, causing it to push high up on the shore. Some people call these times of a day high tide and low tide. One evening, a princess was walking along the seashore, looking at the sea. Suddenly, she saw an island rise up out of the sea and start walking toward the shore. It was not an island. It was the giant crab. The crab was taller than the island's tallest tree and tree or mountain. Then the princess saw the crab's giant pincers and eyes. The crab are looking at the moon when as it rose. The princess saw the crab open its pinches and try to pinch and bite the moon. Its red eyes followed the moon as it climbed higher. Then the crab reached out and tried to grab it. Snap, snap. The crab snapped its pinch. They sounded like thunder. If the crab caught the moon and ate it, the night sky would be dark forever. The princess knew her people were at a feast. People were dancing and having fun. No one would see the crab until it was too late. She needed help to stop the crab from eating the moon. Suddenly, the princess had an idea. She found an empty conch shell, put it to her lips, and blew. A loud noise came down. Boom. The princess looked the crab's giant pincers. Get closer and closer to the moon. Snap, snap, snap. She blew in the shell again and again. The crabs got closer and closer to the moon. The princess blew one more time with the loudest breath yet. As the sound died out, the drums stopped beating. The princess looked toward the village and saw a line of torches coming toward her. The waving line of torches looked like a giant snake coming down the mountainside on the way to the beach. He blew the shell one more time, then ran toward her people. Warrior armed with sword, knives, and spear appeared. Their eyes showed the fear as they looked the largest crab that they had ever seen. It grabbed the moon. A puncher reached higher than before and almost caught the moon, but moon flipped from the crab's grip and the crab fell on its back. The princess grabbed a spear and ran to where the crab are trying to get up. She ran up the side of the crab. She aimed her spear at the crab with crab's soft belly and stabbed him everywhere they sent while dodging the pinchers. One warrior caught one of the pinchers, then the other pincher was cut off. Soon the crab was dead and the moon was set. The bravery of princess saved the moon. The night sky is still lit by the moon. Ship can sail by light of the moon. The water of the oceans still go from high tide to low tide and back again. People say it is full of the moon that causes this tide, but I then dare say it is water still flowing in and out of the crab's home at the bottom of the sea.